All right, let's start with some breaking news that is coming in from the state of Jharkhand. Hemant Soren, it seems, is confident of his numbers. He's saying he will stake claim. In fact, he's saying he'll stake claim today itself. Maria Shakil, Pallavi Ghosh in the studio with us, taking us through the Jharkhand elections and through this piece of breaking news that is coming in. Hemant Soren, Maria, set to stake claim today itself, which means that the Congress party has learned from its Maharashtra experience.
I think it's more to do with Hemant Soren himself here, of course, with RPN Singh clearly announcing that it will be Hemant Soren who will be the chief minister. Now, what sources are telling us clearly that he's likely to address a press conference in some time from now, Shreya. Mm. And thereafter, he will be heading straight to the governor's residence to stake claim. Mm. And interestingly, another detail that is coming now is that Kunal Sarangi, the JMM MLA who joined BJP only in October, is now trailing by 39,000 votes from Bahara Gora. That is a place, that's what we have been told. But certainly, as far as these details that are emerging now, is that Hemant Soren, because the clarity has emerged here, you know, JMM Plus, which is the coalition, pre-poll coalition, pre-poll coalition which contested is at now at 44, BJP at 26. If these numbers hold, I'm told that Hemant Soren will first address a press conference and thereafter he'll be heading straight to the governor's residence, taking no chance at all to stake claim to form the government today itself.
Are you hearing from the Congress at all, Pallavi?
Oh, they're very confident, though a little bit more muted in their reactions. I don't think they want to, you know, kind of celebrate before it's too early. But what they've been saying, of course, is that that they're confident of forming the government. There couldn't be no delay, certainly, from them this side round. And it's Hemant Soren's game, essentially. So the Congress party is also going to project this as a vote against the BJP. I know that CA, Citizenship Amendment Act, NRC, have not really been players, frankly speaking. It's not a referendum on that.
Correct.
But the nature of politics being such, I'm sure the Congress's narrative will be that, look, the people have pointed a finger at the BJP. This is a lesson for the Prime Minister. This is a lesson for the Modi government, that don't do anything which is anti-people, and that's how the Congress
Rahul
party is
Gandhi
going to
in a short while from now will be at Rajghat
at 3 o'clock. Yes, he's supposed to be
a protest. So that's what we are likely to hear, that look, this is the people of this country who have voted against the CA.
I'm sure he's going to tweet before he's going to speak. But yes, it's a dhanna from 3, Satyagraha is what they're calling it. It's from 3 to 8 p.m. Yes, of course. I mean, I'm sure Rahul Gandhi will say something to that effect, that the people of India have, you know, spoken out.
Prabhakar Kumar, you're joining us live as well. I'm going to put this question to Maria as well. What went wrong for the BJP? Multiple things, I believe. Not just one, but there were multiple things that simply didn't work for the BJP this time.
See, before, and actually, before coming to the point as to what went wrong for BJP, I would rather put it that way, what worked for Mahagathbandhan or Congress. It was basically their campaign, very, very precise, very in a surgical strike manner, they had carried out the campaign. So if you see the geography of demography and geography of Jharkhand, they had specific campaigns in specific regions, actually. So if you talk about the industrial area like Bokaro, Jamshedpur, Dhanbad, they were talking about unemployment there, exploitation of mineral resources of Jharkhand, lack of employment, and outsiders actually coming and encroaching their terrain, the interests of the tribals. So basically, the way they had planned the entire campaign, Mahagathbandhan, and ironically, BJP did not counter any of them. So they were banking on the national narrative which they build, like the 370 and Ayodhya and CA, which actually came in the middle of the Jharkhand election. So they were hoping that they would ride that wave, which actually didn't work for them.
So, you know, just to add to what Prabhakar was saying, the opposition here managed to keep it a very localized election. And in that, they worked on it on the basis of various regions. The fact that the BJP has lost in urban pockets, such as Dhanbad, Bokaro, is an indication of how the urban vote was also looking at local issues rather than the national issues of CAA or NRC or other issues. So it clearly means that yes, the opposition had it right. And also, Shreya, just to add to what Prabhakar was saying, the seats that share their border with Bengal, the BJP has lost those seats as well. So certainly this narrative that yes, Prime Minister Narendra Modi is the biggest brand and Jharkhand voted for the BJP, voted for brand Narendra Modi in the month of May. But when it comes to local elections, they are looking at local leaders. And this is again an important message here, that the template which started perhaps in Maharashtra, where opposition came post elections here, it was an experiment in which they tried to ensure that anti-BJP vote is consolidated in one place, which is JMM, RJD and the Congress here.
But Pallavi, do you see the story getting over today?
Because
Maria is reporting that Hemant Soren is fairly confident. The numbers are looking good for them. They'll probably go and stake claim today But do you think the story is over today, given that kuch bhi ho sakta hai, the BJP can well turn out and say, bhaiya, we have 26, we are the single largest party.
We saw what happened in Maharashtra and now kuch bhi ho sakta hai. I mean, you know, just for the sake of it, what stops Hemant Soren, for example, from walking out of the Congress and do a Maharashtra on the Congress party and go along with the BJP? That cannot. What Congress is telling me is that we are going to wait for the last vote is counted. That's when we're going to have a meeting. And it's only after that we'll think of taking place.
But that means that this will stretch till 7:38. I mean, you know,
I don't think the Congress really wants to take a chance. I mean, it will be egg on their face, Shreya, if they're going to start counting their
chickens.
No,
the last vote will be counted by what time? It will be 7:38, I'm assuming?
I think they're going to wait for the official result which comes out from the election commission, I guess. So, yeah, that could be late evening.
Maria, and are you picking up that?
Yes, Shreya, those visuals, interesting rather. Uh-huh. That's the visual of Hemant Soren meeting his father,
Shibu Soren.
And the visuals have just come in now. And I've just been informed by his office as well that he went to meet Shibu Soren just few minutes back. And that meeting has just ended. And thereafter, he'll be addressing a press conference, because the clarity has clearly emerged. This number is only increasing. It's not going down. As far as the ECI website, those numbers that we are flashing now is from the Election Commission of India website.
So are you telling me that the Congress and Hemant Soren, that's the JMM, are not on the same page as far as going to the governor today itself is concerned? Pallavi is saying the Congress
will wait for... I think they would want to go to the governor today itself. I mean, they wouldn't want to make a mistake which they made even in Haryana. Forget Maharashtra. Look what they did in Haryana. They opened their channel of communication with Chautala after dilly-dying for 1 or 2 days. They were waiting for Chautala to reach to them. But you have to go to them also. So I don't think the Congress would want to waste time. But I think they're just being very careful. What they're saying is, we're being very careful. We're going to wait for the last vote to be counted. They have back channel talks which have been going on. And it's not that the Congress is not in touch with Hemant Soren. And of course, they're in touch with him. They are talking to him. The permutation combinations, all of that are being worked out. So we're just looking at a timeline of the official results coming in from the Election Commission and then officially saying, okay, fine. And I don't think they would want to delay beyond today.
And we heard from RP Singh as well, who's saying that, you know, forget our pre-poll allies, we are going to reach out to other anti-BJP candidates as well.
I believe it's 45 three. Now, Shreya. Just look at the numbers. I'm just saying that they will not be taking any chance.
I don't even think they would need support from anybody. Any other small party.
This is a pre-poll alliance, Pallavi.
This is a pre-poll alliance.
This is a pre-poll alliance.
So they don't need it.
Yes.
But, you know, the winning side always is like the magnet. They start attracting the smaller political parties.
Correct.
So when
you
send out this message, listen, I'm in a position to form a government, getting the smaller parties on your side is not going to be too difficult. See, one thing also is there. The Congress party also knows that BJP is not like any other political party. They're always going to make you sit on the edge. So it's best to be safe in numbers.
Okay. And right now, their numbers are looking good, as Maria is pointing out. Just take a look at the screens, the scroll, you know, that is running on the screens, right below on the screens. Congress plus 45, the BJP 25, this is minus 12, which means 12 seats down from last time. Maria, has the manthan already started within the BJP? Hua to hua kya? Because you have a prime minister who has, you know, gone to Jharkhand more than a couple of occasions to...
Yes, nine rallies of the prime minister, which covered 33 constituencies. Then Amit Shah also
This is Maria, just a minute. And Pallavi, just take a look at this. This is the big breaking now coming in. I think we've already pointed it out to our viewers. The BJP is no longer the single largest party in Jharkhand. Yes, we'll wait for the last vote to be counted. But as of now, as we speak, it is 3-9. Election Commission trends and results are clearly showing that the BJP and the JMM are now tied at 26. So that argument, Maria and Pallavi, of the BJP being the single largest party, that doesn't hold anymore. I mean, of course, it could go anywhere.
Yes.
We are still waiting for the last vote to be counted.
Yes,
but Election Commission trends are showing that the BJP is not the single largest party.
JMM is the single largest party at 28. JMM alone is the single largest party at 28, along with the Congress and the RJD, which is the pre-poll alliance. You know, because the BJP said, even in the case of Maharashtra, that it was the Shiv Sena BJP which got that mandate. And that it was the Shiv Sena which cheated that mandate which was and given the BJP, of the people's mandate.
BJP see, the point is, Shreya, and you know, like Maria's pointing seats. Out, I think the politics has completely changed. I mean, this whole thing of pre-poll alliance, the sanctity of this ideology matters. All that has gone for a toss. Barring the BJP and the Congress forming a government together, just about anything else is possible.
Also, I was just pointing this out to our viewers. Let's remember that the BJP has fought twice as many seats as the JMM.
Yes.
And the JMM is leading in 28 and the BJP in 24. So these are the election commission trends that are now coming in. The BJP no longer the single largest party. Maria, we were talking about the chintan and the manthan within the BJP ki hua to hua kya. The Prime Minister holds 9 rallies in the state of Jharkhand. Amit Shah goes there and says things about the NRC and the CAA. I mean, what went wrong for
Ram
the BJP?
Mandir
the Ram Mandir as well. What went wrong?
I think what went wrong here
and
would
were they prepared, more importantly?
Not really. I think there was this sense within the party that they may just form the government. Mm-hmm. That it would be tough, but with some smaller parties, they will be able to form the government. Mm-hmm. But now with that number at 24 and the alliance at 46, it looks almost impossible mm-hmm. that the BJP will be even making an effort at government formation, because this clearly is a mandate against them, Shreya. Mm-hmm. And I understand that there will be some kind of distinction that will be made, because as far as the popular vote is concerned, the percentage that is being projected right now at the Election Commission website, the BJP doesn't seem to have lost too much of it. They may not have converted as many seats. Mm. So that is something that the party will be talking about it. And of course, at the same time, that Raghuvar Das was not a very, very popular chief minister. Mm-hmm. They had tried to keep this election yes on the national issues, but there were feedback that was coming from the ground that the chief minister himself was not very popular. As far as brand Narendra Modi is concerned, that remains the biggest brand on the national level. But when opposition manages to make it local on local issues, localized elections, that's where the challenge comes for the BJP.
Let's speak a little bit about Raghubar Das, I beg your pardon. He's trailing in his own constituency. Saryu Roy, Rai, there's a confusion about whether it's Rai or Roy. But anyhow, Saryu Roy is the one who's leading there. Rebel, all right, I believe Mr. Hemant Soren, and this was expected, has won his election from Barahite. This was something that is that was expected, so that has happened.
And even from the other seat, Shreya,
Dumka as well. So he's won both his seats, and you have Raghubar
Das.
He's
leading by 4,180 votes is what I've been told just now. Mm. This is after 15th round, so clearly, because this is their bastion, this is the family bastion seat, which he had lost last time, although he had one from Barat, but this time he's winning from both these seats. This is from where he had contested in the past. His own father, Shibu Soren, had contested on several occasions in the past. So for them, winning Dumka is more important than this particular constituency, because Barat voted for Hemant last time as well.
So, you know, going back to Raghubar Das, the incumbent chief minister, the only one in the last 19 years, Pallavi, to complete a five-year term, what went wrong for him? People said there was arrogance. A lot of people in, you know, Jharkhand were talking about ghamand. There were a disconnect with the crowd.
Yeah.
The tribals were upset with him because of the Land Acquisition Act, which made it easier for corporates to get
which
land.
Which is why the slogan of the opposition was about, you know, Jal Jeevan, land and all of that. Yeah.
They also lost the OBC vote, I believe. The urban vote and the OBC vote.
So he was always looked like, towards the end, and I think the opposition, and particularly Hemant Soren, more than a Congress party, it's actually JMM plus, frankly speaking. It's a Congress is just a kind of a bystander. Mm. But I think that's what they're capitalizing on, that he's an outsider. He never understood the pulse of the people of Jharkhand. You know, the disconnect on the ground and the Saryu Roy factor, that factor also. I mean, I don't know, Maria, could the BJP have actually understood or factored in this Saryu factor? Maybe they could have projected him as the CM face. I mean, why couldn't the BJP say no to a Raghubar Das doing how unpopular
but why
he was
would
on the ground?
Why would the BJP not want to give the desired ticket to someone who was seen as a clean, honest leader? That is Saryu Roy. His whole plank was what? Anti-corruption. Why would you not want to give the guy the seat that he wanted?
You know, Shreya,
you pushed him to
Raghubar Das in Jharkhand. Manohar Lal Khattar in Haryana.
Hmm.
Again, Devendra Fadnavis in Maharashtra. These were leaders who came suddenly on the scene. Hmm. They were there, yes, working, but they were chosen by the BJP president, Amit Shah, as someone who could lead in these particular states. The reason was, of course, in case of, Raghuvar Das, that he was non-tribal. They were trying to create a counter constituency in a state which has already always voted for and largely voted for a chief minister who has been a tribal chief minister. They were hoping for this kind of consolidation. In Haryana, that did not really work, you know, because they had to finally get a Jat to be part of their coalition in Dushyant Chautala. And that is the reason why I would say that there would be thinking whether that strategy which worked 5 years back, is it continuing on ground? And what is the reason for this kind of resentment? As Prabhakar was pointing out rightly, that in several parts of this Jharkhand, the issues were about jobs. The issues were about tribal rights. It was about Jal. It was about basic land rights. And that is where people realized, perhaps, that Raghuvar Das, who was a non-tribal, was failing to understand the issues and interests of tribals of the state.
You know, a question that multiple people have asked, and I think they are asking in hindsight, Prabhakar, is, why did the BJP decide to go alone? I mean, had they tied up with the AJSU, chances are that the OBC vote would have stayed with them. Prabhakar, that question was for you.
Sorry, Shia, come again.
All right, I'm asking, you know, this is a question.
It was basically because of the hard bargain which Sudesh Mahato had put up, actually. And you're right that it could have helped BJP in certain pockets of Jharkhand, but not in the entire state. So Sudesh Mahato has a presence and strong presence in few pockets of Jharkhand. There BJP could definitely have benefited. As of now, as the results are coming, we don't even know whether BJP has done fairly well in those pockets or not, because we don't know whether how they have performed there. So it is after the results come we can actually say whether this marriage of Sudesh Mahato and BJP would have actually benefited them on the ground. But talking about that kuch bhi ho sakta hai factor, we were talking to Hemant Soren, the close coterie a few days back, and they were from day one decided that if they have this kind of mandate, they would not wait even a minute to go to the governor and stake a claim to form the government, because they are fearing that kuch bhi ho sakta hai factor of BJP. That is the worst fear they have, and they had already decided that they would not waste a minute, they would not give any room for anybody to maneuver anything, and they would straight away head to the governor house, and that is exactly what is playing out now.
And the BJP is at 25. The trends are changing. It sometimes goes down to 23. It's 25 right now, so they are minus 12 since last time. The Congress JAM at 46. From this situation, from here onwards, kuch bhi ho sakta hai kehna will be a little tough, Pallavi.
Oh yes, I am more or less. I think they are safe now. But yeah, I mean, it's going to be interesting to listen to what Hemant Soren has to say in his press conference. I think we'll get more clarity on whether they're going to stake the claim. I still asked by Congress source over there. They're still saying we're going to wait for the last vote to be counted. We just want to be safe, and of course, we're going to try and not waste any time, to use their words, which means highly likely they're going to ask time from the governor to stake their claim, which could be today. If the governor gives time as early as today, then that happens today, or it happens tomorrow. That's a lesson which I think the Congress party needs to learn.
While we are looking at micro details, there are more images that are coming from Hemant Soren's team.
He's already decided he's the next chief minister of Jharkhand.
No, but he has gone
sending
to
out pictures for the last 1 hour. Yes, he's sending pictures of his father there.
He'll be putting out images with his mother and wife as well. And another very interesting seat that if we can spend a little more, I mean, just to add to that, Shreya, I've been just told that after 12th round, Mahua Manji of JMM is ahead by 2,238 votes in Ranchi city constituency. This is the capital city, and she is the urban affairs minister. She was pitted against the urban affairs minister and a five-time MLA who had won last time with 50,000 votes. So these seats being lost by the BJP are important, because let's not forget that in Haryana, when the BJP was losing those seats, it was largely the ministers who were losing. So when it starts falling, it's largely those bastions of ministers who have been in power for long enough. Somebody like this person who has been a five-time MLA losing that to someone.
As the Chief Minister of the state.
The Chief Minister.
You know, is trailing. That itself tells you a story that is emerging from Jharkhand. It seems Hemant Soren is the man of the match today. The Congress, JM combined, RJD as well, stands at 47. The BJP is down to 24 now. JMM is emerging as the single largest party in the state of Jharkhand. The trends are out. More or less, the trends are out. I think we know which way this election has gone, but we'll wait for a final result to come out from the Election Commission. With that, I'm slipping into a quick break on the show. You can follow CNN News 18 on Twitter, Facebook, and of course, YouTube. And remember to also follow road signs and traffic laws for road safety. You can join Network 18 and Hyundai's initiative towards ensuring road safety in India. Be the better guy.
An internal matter of our country.